Okay, so I'm back again, and we're still talking about the Chuck Taylor. I'm sure you're probably sick of it, but there are a few more things to mention. One, the shoe will never go out of style because the design is so simple that it's easy to fall in love with. It's not ugly. It's an American icon. Any American should own this shoe at least once in their life just to see what it is. Just like an American should buy an American car once in their life just to see how it's different from a Toyota or a Honda. This is probably going to seem a little sappy to some of you, but, you know, this is an American product. I mean, it's not made here anymore. If you want Chucks that were made here, you know, 20 plus years ago, you have to go on eBay and you have to buy someone else's shoes, which I don't recommend for any shoe, especially not Chucks. It's a very individual thing. You don't want to buy someone else's shoes, especially if it's this. It's such an important thing to our history that I don't think anyone will be able to top it in terms of simplicity and popularity. There are shoes that are coming close, but I don't think to the same extent. Like, you have the Air Force One, you have the Adidas Superstar 2. Those shoes come close. The Jordan One, to a lesser extent. But this is the king of them all. I mean, it's gonna be around long after anyone watching this video is dead. So be aware of that. Other things about the shoe. Maybe I covered everything. I don't know. But, of course. The easiest way to customize a Chuck Taylor is to go to Converse.com and pick the colors yourself. I believe it costs about $70 to do so, which is still a hell of a lot cheaper than what most sneakers cost today. And if you really want to show off your individualism, that's the route to go. Or, like I said before, you buy a white pair of Chuck Taylors, you get a Sharpie, draw out the design, then draw it on the shoe. Painstakingly, of course, so you don't ruin the shoe. Most of the shoes have white soles and toe caps, so you can also write on them here and here, all around, except for this part, obviously. You wouldn't want to write on that because it wouldn't come out very well. But basically, this is the shoe for the person who wants to express themselves. If you don't have a pair and you call yourself a sneakerhead, you're an embarrassment to sneakerheads. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. Everybody needs a pair of these. I don't care if you're 5 or 85. You have to own a pair of these once in your life. And that's basically all I have to say about that. This is Converse King. If I left anything out, I obviously won't make another video about it because this video's already in 3 parts and it's the longest one I ever made. But comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace.
Traveling in a freighter combi on a hippie trailhead full of zombies. I met a strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast.
Not very different from what you would see decades ago. The only difference is these are made in China or Taiwan or Vietnam instead of the United States where they were originally made. I think they were originally made in Massachusetts because that's where the company was founded. Why did I say it like that? Meh. Yummy.